here's the cinnamon bell.
This is the story of the Cinnamon Bear and his very marvelous adventures with Judy and Jimmy Barton. But we can't very well meet the Cinnamon Bear until we meet Judy and Jimmy. They are twins, and they live in a big, old-fashioned house. At this very minute, they're in the upstairs sitting room, and from all I can hear, Judy and Jimmy are busily engaged in that very pleasant task of writing letters to Santa Claus. Let's listen.
How are you getting along with your letter, Jimmy?
Oh, pretty well. I guess I've got about everything down here.
Now, don't go asking for everything the way you did last year.
Oh, you girls are all alike. I bet you if we counted the things in your letter and the things in mine, you'd have the most.
I bet you I wouldn't either.
You would.
Well, I won't argue about it. But I bet you my letter's more dignified than yours. Now, stop bothering me so I can finish it. Let me see. P.S. And Santa, there's just one thing more I'd like. A nice red V.L. Is that not right? Jimmy, how do you spell velocipede?
Velocipede. V-A... Oh, you're too old for a velocipede anyway.
I guess maybe you're right.
Judy, Jimmy.
Yes, Mother?
I'm here, Mother.
Have you finished those letters to Santa Claus yet?
Uh-huh. Yes.
That's good, because we've something very important to do.
What's that, Mother?
What do you suppose I have in these cardboard boxes here?
I know. Our Christmas tree ornaments.
Yes, and you promised us we could help you go through them to see if any of them were broken.
Right.
Oh, let's hurry, Mother. I can't wait.
Just a minute. I'll put them right here on the table.
Oh, boy.
I hope that little pink Santa Claus didn't get broken.
We'll see.
Oh, aren't they beautiful?
I'll say. I like those big gold ones especially.
Everything seems to be pretty much in order. All the tinsel is here, the lights. Everything seems to be here except...
Except what, Mother?
Well, I can't see the silver star anywhere.
You mean the big one we always put way up on top of the tree?
Yes, but I don't see it in any of the boxes.
Oh, gee, Mom. I'd feel most awful if anything happened to that old silver star.
Me too. Well, we've had it on top of our tree for years and years. Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without the silver star.
Now, don't cry, Judy. It's probably just misplaced. I remember Uncle Jed took some things up to the attic last year after Christmas. Perhaps he put it away up there.
Could we go up and look for it, Mother?
I don't like to have you running around in that old attic. You might get hurt. Besides, it's too cold.
But, Mother, please, we just got to find the silver star, and we have our sweaters on.
All right, but you've got to promise to be careful and not stay too long.
We won't, Mother. Honest, we won't. Where should we look first?
If Uncle Jed put it away, it's probably in that big trunk in the corner by the window. Be careful you don't hurt your fingers when you open it.
We'll be careful. Come on, Jimmy.
Okay, here we go, up the stairs.
Now, don't run, children. You might fall and get hurt.
All right, Mother dear. Last one up, the fraidy cat.
Jibbilikers. They sure are steep stairs.
Yeah.
They're a lot steeper than Mary Louise has in her house.
I bet these are the steepest stairs in the world.
Sure they are.
Here we are. I beat, and you're a fraidy cat.
You didn't either, Beat. I got here at the same time, and I'm not a fraidy cat.
All right, then, we both beat.
Okay, but if we both beat, who is a fraidy cat?
Oh, Charlie Simpson's a fraidy cat.
Yeah. Gee, there sure is a lot of stuff up in this attic.
Yeah, just look at all those suitcases and boxes and things.
Yeah, and there's that old spinning wheel and the music box. And...
Oh, Judy, there's the old trunk Mother told us to look in.
Must be awful full of things. The top is enclosed all the way down.
Well, you get on one side, Judy, and I'll get on the other. And then we can both lift at the same time.
All right, Jimmy. Gee, that was kind of heavy. Oh, look, Jimmy. There's one of those old crazy quilts right on top. Take it off and we'll see what's underneath.
Okay. There. Smells like mothballs, doesn't it?
Uh-huh. Do you see the silver star anyplace?
Uh-uh. Just a lot of old clothes and stuff. Let's lift this top thing out. Come on, Judy, help me.
All right.
Now, let's see. See, here's a small box of ornaments.
But they're all broken, Jimmy. And the silver star isn't there.
Gee, here's one that's not broken. It's a pretty little airplane. It's made out of gold glass or something.
We'd better take that downstairs with us. Why don't you put it someplace where it won't get broken?
I'd better, I guess. I'll just set it on top of this old dresser here. Find anything else, Judy?
You bet. Look at this, Jimmy. A little teddy bear with a green ribbon around his neck. Gee, he isn't any more than 4 inches high.
Look, look what I found, Judy. A real honest-to-goodness telescope. Isn't it a dandy?
It's scrumptious. I bet that belonged to Uncle Jed when he was a sailor.
I bet so, too. It sure is a wonderful telescope. When I look through it, everything seems a million times bigger. Boy, I bet if I was out on the roof, I could see clear over to England.
Farther than that, maybe. You know what, Jimmy?
What?
This teddy bear is the teeniest one I've ever seen.
Sure is. Say, Judy, I bet if we looked at him through this telescope, he'd be a lot bigger.
Let's see, shall we? I'll lean him against the back of the trunk and you look.
All right. Now, just wait till I get it fixed. Jiminy crickets!
What do you see, Jimmy?
Willikers! He looks bigger than anything. Take a look, Judy.
Let me see. Goodness! He is big, isn't he? Why, he looks almost as big as we are, only he really isn't.
If you'd move over a little, Judy, we could both look at the same time. There. That's it. Can you see him?
Plain as day.
Judy, Judy, he moved. The bear moved. Didn't you see him moving?
I thought I did, but...
Sure he moved. Gosh.
Garage.
Judy, listen. He made a noise.
Maybe it was just a creaky board.
No, it wasn't any creaky board. It was that bear, and I'm going to talk back to him.
Oh, Jimmy, maybe you better hadn't.
Oh, don't get scared. He can't hurt you. He's really only 4 inches high. Hey, you teddy bear.
Garage.
Oh.
Did you hear him, Judy? Did you hear him? He growled at me.
Ooh, he did, didn't he? Say, Jimmy, ask him if he's a really, truly live, real bear.
All right. Hey, teddy bear, tell us, who are you?
I'm the cinnamon bear with the shoe-button eyes, and I'm looking for someone to take by surprise. I go prowling and growling each night after dark. But the folks say my growl's just a cinnamon bark. Though I growl,
garrow,
and I growl,
garrow,
my victims only say, oh, who's afraid of you? I'm the cinnamon bear with the shoe-button eyes, and I'm happy and fluffy and tough for my size. I devour lots of honey and cinnamon buns just to make me ferocious, but nobody runs. Now I'll growl.
Hurrah!
And I'll growl.
Garoo!
And if you act afraid, I'm much obliged to you.
Oh, that was wonderful, Cinnamon Bear.
Garoo!
Jimmy, let's begin. We're really afraid, huh? It'll make him feel good.
Oh, all right.
Oh, don't give us a scare like that again, Mr. Bear.
Garrah.
Oh, Judy, I'm scared.
Garrah.
Oh, Jimmy, hold my hand tight.
Sure, and did I really frighten you?
Terribly.
You just about scared the daylights out of us.
Well, I promise not to frighten you anymore. That is, not until me ferocious nature gets the better of me again. Now, would you be kind enough to tell me your names? I always keep a record of the people I scare.
I'm Jimmy.
And I'm his sister, Judy.
I'm much obliged to meet you, I'm sure. My name's Paddy O'Sullivan.
That sounds Irish.
Sure, I'm slightly Irish. That's why I wear this green ribbon around my neck. But tell me, what are you two doing up here?
Well, we lost a silver star that goes on top of the Christmas tree.
Have you ever seen it, Cinnamon Bear?
A silver star? Did it have 5 points?
I think so.
Sure, I've seen it lots of times.
Oh, show us where the silver star is, Cinnamon Bear.
Oh, it's not here now. It's gone.
Gone?
Oh, dear. What shall we ever do now?
Well, who took it?
Why, the Crazy-Quilt dragon, to be sure.
Who is he?
Oh, just a dragon. Not a very good one at that. He's terribly fond of shiny, bright things. Every day for the past month, he's been running into the trunk to admire the silver star. And this afternoon, it got the best of him, I guess. He just upped and ran off with it.
Oh, now we'll never, never see the silver star again.
Here, now, don't carry on like that. You can get the silver star back. Well, maybe.
How?
By going after the Crazy-Quilt dragon. Chase him. I'll help you.
Will you really?
Oh, sure I will. Crazy-Quilt's no great friend of mine. And besides, you were both very obliging and got perfectly terrified when I growled at you.
Oh, you're the most wonderful cinnamon bear in the whole wide world.
It's very nice of you to say it.
Well, if we're going to catch up with the Crazy-Quilt dragon, we better get going.
Where do you think he went, Patty?
Well, if I know Crazy-Quilt, he probably headed for the Lollipop Mountains.
The Lollipop Mountains? Well, how do we get there?
You see that little hole in the wall by the music box?
Yes.
Well, we just pop right through there.
Oh, but Patty, Judy and I can't get through that little hole.
Oh, yes, you can. It's very simple, really. All you and Judy have to do is degrow.
What do you mean, degrow?
Just degrow. Get smaller and smaller and smaller until you're only 4 inches high, like me.
Gosh, we can't do that. Why, it's impossible.
Nothing's impossible. I can show you how to do it in a jiffy.
Phew, that sounds most magical.
Willikers, show us how, Patty. Quick.
All right. Now listen very carefully, and I'll tell you how to degrow.
Well, well, if the cinnamon bear can show Judy and Jimmy how to degrow until they're only 4 inches high, then as Judy says, it really will be most magical. And maybe they'll be able to catch the crazy quilt dragon and recapture their precious silver star after all. Anyway, be sure to listen next time and find out just how the cinnamon bear manages to make Judy and Jimmy only 4 inches high.